far away. See the lights guiding me, they show me the way. Oh, 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 take my hand, I'll lead you home. Escape our fate, walk alone. Turn down the lights tonight, moon's our guide. We dance, we sing.
Good afternoon and welcome everyone. Love is a miraculous gift. A wedding is a celebration of that magic, and that is what we're here today. We're gathered here on this beautiful afternoon to celebrate the union of Leanne and Evan in a life of mutual commitment. Today we celebrate the best feeling in the world. Today we celebrate love in this great place where you take yourselves out of the usual routines of daily living to witness a unique moment in the life of this couple. Today, they end their lives in the union of marriage. On behalf of Evan and Leanne, I would like to begin by thanking all of you for your love and support. The fact that you all have traveled such a great distance to be here is a testament to the love you have for them. And they would like you to know how grateful they are that you're here to share in their big day. Now please leave behind the worries and concerns of everyday life and celebrate this special day. This is an opportunity for us to share not only in the joy of this couple's love, but also to reaffirm and appreciate the love and friendship we experience in our own lives. To open the ceremony, we will begin with a prayer. Dear God, we ask for your blessings upon this couple as they unite in marriage. Let all their days together be happy and all the words to each other be sweet. Bless their home and allow it to be a place of joy and serenity. Remind them to nurture each other's bodies and souls with mutual love, honor, and respect. As they learn from one another, may they grow stronger as individuals and closer as a couple. Amen. Leanne and Evan, marriage consists of entrusting our deepest selves into loving care of one another. It is more than joining the bonds of two individuals. It is the union of two hearts. It is a connection of two souls. It is the happiness of always being able to talk things over, to confide in each other, to laugh with each other, to enjoy life together, and to share moments of quiet and peace when the day is done. Do you remember how you first met? You saw each other for the first time while you were working together at a restaurant in senior year of high school. And ever since your first date in July 20th of 2013, you started making promises and agreements. And your relationship got stronger day after day. Your love continued growing, so 2 years ago in New York, on Christmas Day, you decided to take the next step in your relationship and got engaged. And now you're standing here, ready to exchange wedding rings and say vows. Those vows that are a way of saying to one another, do you remember all those things that we promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it all, every word. Today, as you join yourselves in marriage, you have a new beginning with a wonderful future before you. The possibilities and potentials of your married life are great, and now falls upon your shoulders the task of choosing your values and making real dreams. Through your commitment to each other, may you grow and nurture love that makes both of you better people. A love that continues to give you great joy, and also the passion for living that provides you with energy and patience to face the responsibilities of life. A couple who are wed must continually renew to be joined and accept the challenges that living together in love offer. I ask you to join hands as a symbol of the union that you're making here today. I'd like you to close your eyes for a second and to think about the hands that you're holding. These are the hands of your best friend, strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future, that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and will give you support and encouragement to chase your dreams. These are the hands that will tenderly hold all those whom you love, the hands that will hold you tight as you struggle through difficult times and will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that in the years to come will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Leanne and Evan, please look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this day, you have been many things to one another: acquaintances, friends, companions, counselors, lovers, and even teachers, for you have learned much from one another over these 6 years that you have been together. And the commitment will grow after the vows when you shall say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife. You are now taking into your care and keeping the happiness of the one person in all of the world whom you love deepest. You are adding to your life not only the affection of each other, but also the companionship and blessing of a deep trust as well. You are going to share strength, responsibilities, and love. And as you both know, to make this relationship work, it takes more than love. It takes trust to know in your hearts that you want only the best for each other. It takes dedication to stay open to one another, to learn and grow even when it is difficult to do so. Marriage is a precious gift that takes a lifelong dedication to love and a daily challenge to love one another completely and freely, and that is why I need to ask. Do you, Evan, take Leanne to be your partner in the adventure that lies ahead? Do you promise to walk by her side to the ends of the earth, to love, encourage, and support her in her every endeavor?
I do.
Do you commit to opening yourself up completely to her and share with Leanne your entire being, to share her laughter as well as tears? Do you take her as your wife from now until the end of time?
I do.
And do you, Leanne, take Evan to be your partner in the adventure that lies ahead? Do you promise to walk by his side to the ends of the earth, to love, encourage, and support him in his every endeavor?
I do.
Do you commit to opening yourself up completely to him and share with Evan your entire being, to share his laughter as well as tears? Do you take him as your husband from now until the end of time?
I do.
And now Leanne and Evan would like to share their own vows.
Well, Evan, from this moment on, our life has begun. It seems like just yesterday we were two young kids without a clue in the world of what the future would hold for us. I didn't know it at the time, but I was looking at the man I was going to marry. And as the days turned to years, we passed life's major milestones together. Hand in hand, we grew up, and without no rhyme or reason, we fell deeply in love and created a strong and unbreakable bond that would last through the good and the bad. The love you give me is something that I can't put into words. And it is then that I know that God has bigger plans for me than I ever had for myself. It's like our journey will never end. It's like you were sent to me to help me through all of this. You're my angel, Evan, made just for me. And it's because of you, I laugh, I smile, and I dare to dream more than I ever have. You are and will always be the love of my life, my soulmate, and my person.
Leanne, you are my best friend, my lover, my everything. When we first met, you were just a 16-year-old girl and I just a 17-year-old boy. Prior to that, I was naive to the world, not knowing what direction I was going or who I wanted to be. That all changed when I met you. You came into my life and instantly became my compass. You guided me into the direction of becoming not only a better man, but a better person. You showed me how to laugh, how to cry, and how to live. But most importantly, you showed me how to love. I am who I am because of you. There are so many things that I love about you. Like how your wet hair is curly but amazingly straight halfway down. It is truly the most beautiful thing I have ever seen. How you rest your head on my lap and close your eyes when you're watching TV. Or the way you always call me on your lunch break and say hi in the most adorable, sweetest voice ever. But the thing I love most about you is your heart. You have the most affectionate, gentle, and caring heart of any person I have ever met. You've always put others before yourself. And for that reason, I've always known you've had the purest of heart. And that is what I have fallen in love with the most. You have made me feel more love than I ever thought possible. Leanne, I promise to love you unconditionally. I promise to comfort you in times, in troubles, and distress. I'll be here with you, encouraging you to achieve your goals, to laugh with you, and to cry with you. I will grow old with you and never stop growing with you. I'll always be at your side, and I will love you for all the days of my life.
Evan and Liam, please look at your rings because they are an external and visible sign of the internal and spiritual bond of love which united two hearts. Your rings say that even in your uniqueness, you have chosen to grow together.
On this day, you are my best friend, the one I share my life, my love, my dreams. Liam, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and devotion. I offer you my heart, my hand, and my soul. I join my life with yours to cherish and protect you as my wife. With all that I am, with all that I have, I honor you as my wife forevermore.
one? Like this? Okay.
On this day.
On this day.
I marry my best friend.
I marry my best friend.
The one who shares my life.
The one who shares my life.
My love and my dreams.
My love and my dreams.
Evan,
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love and devotion.
As a symbol of my love and devotion.
I offer you my heart.
I offer you my heart.
My hand and my soul.
My hand and my soul.
I join my life with yours.
I join my life with yours.
To cherish and protect you as my husband.
With all that I am.
With all that I have.
With all that I have.
I honor you as my husband.
I honor you as my husband forevermore.
With these rings, promises become permanent, and two friends become family. Let these rings always remind you both that you are part of something bigger, a bond built on a strong foundation of trust, respect, and love. Now please come to the side of the table to sign certificate of marriage. This is a small present, and also ask you a couple of things. Please keep in mind that your marriage will be a journey full of surprises and the opportunity of writing a wonderful story is completely yours. So when you have a dream about your future, please write it down. When you have a happy moment, like the one you're living today, keep it here. Write about all the things you enjoy doing together, like when you dance, and about the time you spend with each other, family. You can start your notebook by describing the qualities which make you beloved, special and unique, and the reasons why you fell in love. This simple practice puts more love, appreciation, and acknowledgement into your relationship, and it can make every future endeavor more fruitful and joyous. So please, write here all your dreams and all your happy memories, and this way your home and your hearts will always be filled with love. And now the last request. Leanne and Evan, your wedding day is one that seems to fly. It's a day filled with emotions, family, friends, dances, toasts, a lot of toasts, plenty of joy, and that is why it's important for you to take a few seconds to look in your eyes and to think about the happiness that you're feeling in this place, in this very moment. Remember, this day is all about you and it's all about your love, so please think about your feelings and let them register in your heart and your mind. Now close your eyes again. And think about your life in 10, 20 years from now. Visualize all your achievements together and the joy you are feeling then, and keep it in your heart too. I ask that your home may be a place of bliss for all who enter it, a place for growing, a place for music and celebration, a place for laughter. May you always live in harmony, unity, love, and happiness from this day forward, and may your union be forever blessed. Please open your eyes. And well, Evan and Leanne, you have expressed your love to one another through the commitment and promises you have just made. It's with this in mind that I now pronounce you husband and wife. Evan, you may not kiss your bride.
Life and building us a city. There's all this time live a lifetime every moment when I'm holding you close. Lay your head down on my shoulder, honey, I won't ever let go. Because you pulled me like a magnet, now I'm right where I belong. I'm gonna love you the same for the rest of my days, and on and on and on. Cause as long as we keep dancing, we'll stay young at heart. And every time I hold you in my arms.
Welcome to the remix, the one insuperable.
for sure. She was sent here from heaven, and she's daddy's little girl. As I drop to my knees by her bed at night, she talks to Jesus, and I close my eyes, and I thank God for all of the joy in my life. Oh, but most of all, for butterfly kisses after bedtime prayer, sticking little white flowers all up in her hair. Walk beside the pony, daddy, it's my first ride. I know the cake looks funny, daddy, but I sure tried. Oh, with all that I've done wrong, I must have done something right to deserve a hug every morning and butterfly kisses.
You taught me everything, everything you've given me. I always keep it inside. You're the driving force in my life. Yeah. There isn't anything or anyone that I could be, and it just wouldn't feel right if I didn't have you by my side. You were there for me to love and care for me when skies were gray. Whenever I was down, you were always there to comfort me. And no one else can be what you have been to me. You will always be, you will always be the girl in my life for all time. Mama, Mama, you know I love you. Ooh, you know I love you, Mama. Mama, you're the queen of my heart. Your love is like tears from the stars.
Yes, it's it.
Mama, I just want you to know.
Yes it is, oh, yes it is, yes it is, yes it is.
Free. You know, I went every evening and every week before this wedding and tried to prepare for this speech. And I got to tell you, I don't feel like I'm prepared. But I got to tell you, I want you, you're ready to hear something. So marriages, Evan and Leanne, my theme tonight is a new beginning. New beginning. Think about what that means. Marriages like birth mark a new beginning. The day I drove my sweetheart, daughter, from the hospital after she was born, it was a new beginning for me. To be a father of a daughter seemed a bit overwhelming, but anticipation of, for her life and for our relationship helped me overcome the fears and work hard to be the father worthy of such a daughter. Today we stand at another new beginning as Leanne and Evan start a brand new family. Like me, they are probably filled with feelings of being a little overwhelmed at all. But those feelings will melt away in large part as they anticipate their new life together and as they build a relationship that will stand, and I hope will stand the test of time. And I would say, be true to each other, always. Share your joys and your burdens. Love much, laugh much. Be each other's best friend. Always speak well of one another, even in private. And when things don't go well, forgive as often as it is required. Married life is an adventure, and you embark today on that adventure together. Even though you are individuals, your covenant today makes the couple more important than either you of you separately. Either of you separately. One day, if you're as fortunate as I've been, you will stand in awe of a new life entering your family. That will be another beginning filled with apprehension and anticipation. Bring that relationship the same level of love and commitment you do with your marriage, and you will find joy beyond compare. So today, your friends and family surround you as you begin something new and marvelous. Remember your promises. Keep them with all your heart, and you will find and have the sense of joy and wonder that exceeds all of your heretofore you've known. With all of my heart, I offer you my congratulations and warmest wishes as you begin the latest adventure that life has to offer. Thank you. Evan, you better take care of her.
I will, yes, sir.
All right.
So listen, guys, I got to tell you that I had to clear this speech through your family, okay? So they all approved it, even James. So thank you. But anyway, today, I mean, it's a blessed day, right? This is a gorgeous couple, young. I remember taking care of this girl and taking care of Ray as I was a clinician back then, right? Right? All the vaccines, all those things. But today I want to talk to both of you about something that I find extremely serious, right? And that's called courage. And courage, you can't dress it up, man. You can't wear a suit and be courageous. So I'm going to tell you 7 acts that I talk about all the time, right? I want you to dream and put forth that dream. Make it big, man, or stay home, right? Make it big. Dream. and get it out there. I want you to recognize your current reality. Where are you? Who are you? What do you want to do? What do you want to be? Right? What do you need to get? And go get it. I'll be there to help you. The courage to confront, stand up. When you got a problem, man, say it. Say it. It may be painful, but say it. So the courage to confront. The courage to be confronted, right? How do you take feedback? How do you accept it? Do you learn from it? The courage to learn and grow. Read something every day. I don't care if it's a soda pop top. Read something every day and grow, okay? Learn to be vulnerable. The courage to be vulnerable is the courage that you have today, like to love and to feel free. You're surrounded by incredible family, right? We all love you, you know that. And the last courage that I tell you about that many people don't do is the actual courage to act. Take that step forward. It's not a cliff, it's a mirage. Take it forward. Love you guys.
All right, so as Leanne's older brother, I've always felt responsible for her. I wanted to protect her from everything growing up, and it was especially easy since she would literally follow me everywhere I went. I vividly remember the days when she would sneak into my room in the middle of the night when she was scared, and I would wake up on the edge of my bed nearly falling off. So, Evan, get ready, she's a bed hog. She's a huge bed hog. All jokes aside, today my baby sister is the bride. Sis, I just want you to know how proud I am to stand with you as you wed. You are my childhood playmate, adversary, confidant, and friend. All of my best memories have you in them. You have chosen a husband for yourself and a brother for me, whom I admire and respect. And I have to say, I'm thankful for your judgment in this matter. To the groom, I thank you for making the overprotective brother theft unnecessary. Like, you've definitely you've been very good to my sister. I appreciate that. I appreciate how you care for my sister, one of the most important people in my life. I hope and pray we will all be friends and family for a lifetime. May God bless you with a holy marriage, healthy lives, and prosperity and abundance. May your love be the stuff in which poets and authors dream of. All my love to both of you. Everybody, please raise your glasses to the bride and groom.
Okay, first of all, I'm not really good at giving speeches, so I'm just, whatever. Anyways. My dear friends, Leanne and Evan, I'm so happy for you guys. I couldn't be any happier. I'm gonna be the one to get emotional. I'm pissed. Okay. I'm so happy for you guys. We've all been waiting for this day for so long. Yes or no, we've all been waiting for this day for so long. To be honest, Leanne has been planning this moment since the moment I met her. She's been planning this day. You know, Evan, she really has. I don't know what to tell you. Evan, you have shown her nothing but respect and love since the moment you met her, and I cannot think of a more qualified husband for my friend. I know that you will always try and go above and beyond for her. Okay, let me stop. Okay. I cannot think of a more qualified husband for my friend. I know that you will always try and go above and beyond for Leanne, and Leanne, I know you will do the same for Evan. Never let that respect fade. It won't always be easy, but I can assure you it will be worth it. love is worth fighting for. Never go to sleep mad. Always say I love you. Always remember to tell each other how much you appreciate one another, and most importantly, always forgive. It's the little things that will keep your marriage alive and on fire. Leanne and Evan, this is the beginning of a new chapter. The time has come for you two to write your own story. Make it a good one, because you know we live for a good story. Always remember, where there is love, there is miracles. I love you both dearly, like my family. The end.
That was beautiful.
I'm Evan's older brother. I know him better than any of you. Sorry, I'm gonna take that claim. And normally, the best men get to tell a story that's really embarrassing on the groom's part. Unfortunately, I racked my brain. I couldn't find one, because Evan is such a stand-up guy. But I did find an embarrassing story that tells you how stand-up he is and what a clown I was. Not so long ago, we were at another wedding, the wedding of my stepfather and mother. And we were much younger than we are now. Considerably younger. I was circa 15, 16, Evan was circa 11 or 12, and I made a fool of myself, and I got a little carried away at the party, and I'll spare you the details, you can probably fill in the rest. Around 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning, I started feeling those consequences, and it showed. And at 11 years old, my little brother heard and woke up, dragged me outside, and you know, this might be hard for some of you to believe, he wasn't always a freakazoid, as tall as he was. He was about half my size at this time. He took me outside, rubbed my back, brought me water, and waited until I was done, took me inside, dragged me inside, fireman style, stripped me down, buck naked, threw me in the bathtub, and waited for me to get better. And at 11 years old, I was completely blown away. Well, I wasn't, he was 11. That kind of caregiving, that kind of nurturing, that instinct is the best way that I would describe Evan. Unbelievable, unconditional love and support. Second part, I get to tell about how, you know, I had my part in this meeting. I was a bartender at Fuego. I got Evan his first job there. And as you've heard from my mother, Evan was a little shy. So I took it upon myself, as a lot of you who do know me know, I have a hard time keeping my mouth shut and keeping things in. But I heard about this Leanne chick, you know, as brothers do. They came in after I did. And so I got to come back and visit from school one day, and I kept hearing about, oh, does this girl I really like? Does this girl I really like? But, you know. So, you know, I get to go to Fuego with my aunt and uncle there here, John and Susan. And, you know, I was like, you know, maybe this could use a little push, you know, so maybe I'll use my big mouth to my advantage. And I made sure that she was in earshot when she sat out, so I was like, that's the one. Yeah, that's the one Evan's been talking about. She heard me. So, you know, I did my part, and my theme for the evening is gonna be communication. Some of you that don't know us, we're very different. You know, one's really tall, I'm pretty short, you know. We have a lot of things that are different about us, but one thing that my brother and I have in common, the Latina fever. And sorry, that's what it is. I got my wife, Puerto Ricana. See, you know, there's something in the food. Something that y'all are putting in the food that's, you know, it is what it is. Sazón, sí, claro. But, you know, so what I really wanted to tie this up with, you know, the importance of communication, and a lot of people always like, communicate, communicate, communicate. What does that mean? what does that look like? And I've always wanted that question answered. And I've found in my own personal experience a lot of times, what I would like to just say to you is communication is often not what we want to hear or say. But, you know, on building on the aspect of courage and all those things, it's important to communicate those things. And the second thing I'm going to say is, in front of all these people, in front of God, y'all made a union to become one. And this is very important. But I would ask that you respect the individual that you fell in love with and remember who it was that you fell in love with. And that means sometimes supporting things and going to things that you want to go to. football games, all of that stuff, what have you. You know, but it's important to be there for each other, and it's going to go both ways. And the other thing, respect. Respecting each other's wishes, expecting each other's... I'm sorry. It's okay. Respecting each other's identities and just respecting each other. And Evan, do what Mom and Doug taught you to do. Leanne, he's your problem now. Ever since like I could remember, I've always wanted a little sister, and I'm so excited to have one now. So I wish y'all the best of luck.